sunshine.
Come on in.
On April 20th, 2023, Team Toasting traveled over to Champaign, Illinois for Spring Explosion to go for it all.
You want to take that?
Early Thursday morning, drivers and crew members worked to get the cars ready to go through inspection for the very first time.
Here about 6:30 last night. We wanted to get here early. We came over as a team, all came together. We drove slow. It was windy coming over here. We had a lot of equipment and a lot of campers with us, so it was quite the experience getting here, but it just makes us stronger going through stuff like that together. So we all made it here safe and we're happy to be here. I hope inspection goes well. I'm sure we'll have a few things to cut. Shouldn't be too bad. Based on some of the other cars we see here, I think we're going to be just fine, inspection wise. So hopefully it goes well and we're not working too hard today.
It wasn't too bad. I mean, just had to drive slow, a little windy, but we got here 6:30, somewhere around there, and just kind of took our time getting stuff off the trailer set up. So we went out to mess with it this morning, had a little fun and didn't get too wild, but good evening, just to relax. Hopefully everything goes well. I mean, built the car to the rules and didn't do nothing too crazy, so I don't see nothing they can really complain about, but they'll find something probably. So.
The inspection line was nothing but short, so drivers had to wait over an hour just for their cars to be looked at. The first member of Toasting to be inspected would be the 40P of Zach Pendleton.
We gotta get through my list before we get you.
Next up on the lift would be the 727 of Tim Atkins.
Hey.
Following after his teammates would be the 417 of Jared Payton, whose car was looked at a little longer than others. Last but not least for Toast Inc. would be the 70 of Mike Patton.
I drilled through the and put a 3/8 bolt. Yeah.
Yeah. Because yeah, there's a, I mean,
I just couldn't get it to line back up, so yep, we just buzzed it.
Shouldn't really be welded to the engine cradle.
So just cut that weld where it's
right
connected
there
to the cradle?
Yep.
Got
don't
it
cut your fucking frame, man.
Yeah, no, I get it.
Melissa, did you get that one? Nope. A-arm strap can be cut free from engine cradle. Steering stops.
What's wrong with steering stops? Doesn't say you can't have them.
It's not factory. It says all steering components must be factory.
They are factory. I just got a nut welded on an A-arm. It's not strengthening the A-arm. It's stopping the...
The nut's not stuck, though.
It's just keep a breaking racks.
Yep. Healy's tendon.
Hell, you already don't give us a plate.
You like that? Not so much.
The hell with that plate.
Whoops. Feeling coke on you.
Huh? Yeah, I knew I'd have to cut those.
Windshield bar needs to be cut free. No welds. Yeah, bye.
Yep. It's plated. It's got a plate bolted to the firewall.
That's how they hit. He has it.
Yeah. Mind. It's just a plate and then bolted. So really, I should just have to cut this and the welds up there, right? We already had it in, then realized we couldn't weld it, so we went ahead and bolted it up there.
Yeah, just cut those off.
Yep, got it.
Ignore that one.
Yep. Yeah.
You see this?
What's that?
You can plug weld that when the bolt broke, would you?
Yeah, he said if I wanted to too, I could drill through this and put a 3/8 bolt in it or something after I cut it.
Okay.
Yep. I asked him about it.
Okay.
What's this line here? Just
gotta come up.
How come?
It's got to be 6 inches away from your trunk pan, and you jack your trunk pan up.
Yeah, your trunk pan's on top of the rail from here to here. If you measure this way from the rail, 6 inches.
I measure a gap.
Gotcha. So just blow some holes in this, kind of yank it up. Got it. Just want to make sure I do the things the way you want it done.
Yeah.
And I'm assuming that's just because that's sheet metal to sheet metal. Okay.
I'm okay with that. It's still short enough. If it was long, then...
Do I have to cut the plates? Or what? What's going on with these? Are we not allowed to weld the tops of the doors?
I believe that was the driver's door.
Okay. Got it. Cooler line did leak the other day, but I tightened it up, so it must just be some residual shit, maybe, hopefully. I'll have to check that out. Nothing on that. I just tilted the thing. That's it.
Look right here. You can see where
there's no gap.
As well, it's starting to bubble right here.
Yep.
But there's a gap on this side.
That's why this side is pushed in. This cradle's pushed into the frame because it sucked it in. Fucker good there, too.
But there's a gap over here, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't pull, like, I don't know if that's just the way it's sitting, but there's a gap on this side. So. Trunk's fine, I think, other than raising it up.
Told you.
So the all thread, the nut shot needs to be down farther.
The bottom nut.
Yep.
Down some.
Or take the top one off.
One or the other, right?
Yep.
Okay.
It just can't be double nutted.
Okay. Because I'll probably take the top one off to try to wedge the
yep
all thread.
Push
yeah
it against.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oops, sorry, buddy.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't have all that shit welded.
That's a good thing.
I'm too lazy for that shit. And too fat to get in the trunk.
Coming in. Yeah.
Thank you, dear. And then just clarify that A-arm strap was just from the cradle, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep, you can leave the rest of it, just the cradle.
Cut
yeah, just buzz the weld, make
yeah
sure you don't cut
yep
the
yep. All pretty simple, thanks.
Thank you.
Once all teammates made it back from inspection, they got right to work, as they each had a list of things that they needed to do. Jared Payton having the longest list. With all hands on deck, drivers and crew members finished everything up to go through reinspection in the morning, all before Mother Nature came by for a visit.
Alright, Caden, I'm good. Thank you, buddy.
After waking up early and going through inspection as the first cars through reinspection, Team Toast Inc. was ready for the day on Friday, while officials prepare the track for today's action.
A little windy yesterday, but everything went real well. We helped each other out. Got it done. Beat the rain, and it was a pretty successful night, if I have to say so myself.
Thought the guys were really easy to work with.
Yeah.
And the inspection went really well.
Yeah. Yeah, a little better than we anticipated. So we'll see how it turns out for us today. But. We're ready for the heat draw. The anticipation of who we draw, this is a draw game, right? So the anticipation of who we draw is kind of wearing on us a little bit, but once we find that out, I think our nerves will settle a little bit and we'll be able to form a game plan and move on with that.
That's why we let Tim do all the talking.
Oh, yeah. Exactly.
Before the action can kick off, drivers had to attend the driver's meeting to find out which heat they'd be competing in. Heats would consist of four-man teams going head-to-head, with the winning team advancing to the feature.
That was the call, right? Man, we try the best that we can. We try to make it fair for absolutely everybody, but sometimes shit happens. I get it. Don't come bump rushing because it's not heat two.
Big.
CFM versus 5150. Eight is Saunders Oil, Toast Inc.
In the heat draw, Team Toast Inc. drew Team Saunders Oil. They would be heat number eight of the night. So now it was time to go back, relax, and wait for their turn. Before they knew it, it was go time. Heat 8 was just around the corner and drivers were locked in, strapped down, and ready to go. after a very fast-paced heat race, Team Toasting came away with a win. It came down to the 727 of Tim Atkins and the 417 of Jared Payton surviving for the Toasting victory. The 70 of Mike Patton lost steering in reverse as the 40P of Zach Pendleton got stuck on the wall. As soon as all the cars got back from the track, they knew it was crunch time. Time to do any means necessary to get their cars ready for the feature and a chance to win Spring Explosion.
Kicks 5.5, probably fucking metric, 5.11.
Know what to look for.
Zach knows exactly what he's fucking told to do.
That's absurd.
Did the battery go over the
head? No, this shit.
Hey, come back on the other side. I'm trying to build.
I'm gonna go get some snips out of the trailer.
Yeah. Hey, you got that fry ball up?
Yeah, I'm trying
to. Here's off.
Hey, LP?
Yeah.
Hey, let me take these lines loose first. Let's say I'll probably have you go dump this pan out over there. And then I need the torch brought over here.
To be centered, you gotta come to me. Go down just a little bit, can you?
Yep.
one bit of steam out of this thing. Not usual.
He did exactly as planned.
I said,
we couldn't. You don't understand how proud I am of you.
Yeah.
Yeah. 9/16 LP.
Did it burn up inside or what?
I don't know. There's no reverse. What's that about? That's
all good.
Did you get it with a deep well? What?
Silicone for Mike, it's in the back of the
tree. Well, need better.
Then I'll plate it with all that pressure on it.
May have to put something on that side to pull it over. All right. We have to put a chain on that side. Let's get it there.
Well, whatever we can find, you guys will give us whatever we need.
See if we can find another chain to go on.
Drivers and crew members worked the rest of the day, all night, and into the early morning on those cars to get them ready to rock and roll for the feature on Saturday. has arrived. Feature time. Team Toast Inc. is looking to be the last team standing. A pretty slow paced start to the feature until the 70 of Mike Patton was hit with a curveball. If being in a cloud of smoke wasn't enough, trouble struck the 70 again as his engine went up in flames. after that fire, that would be the end of the line at Spring Explosion for Mike Patton, which leaves Toast Inc. with only three drivers left. After a stoppage on the track for debris, it happened to be courtesy of the 417 of Jared Payton as he lost a rear axle. The number of cars remaining was dwindling and the three members of Toast Inc. were giving it all they had, until two members got knocked out very close together. that left just the 417 of Jared Payton left. Fought off the other teams for as long as he could by himself, the 417 of Payton called it quits. It's the end of the line for Toast Inc.